Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy from Van Auten Company. It is Friday, October 16th. I'm going to go over the markets for the day and week with you. So corn market kind of getting stuck here between wheat and soybeans. Soybeans finding a bit of selling pressure off extended forecasts of Brazil getting some moisture. And honestly, not surprising that you're just seeing a little bit of a pullback here in soybeans after so much strength. So down 12 and a quarter today. That puts them down 15 and a half cents overall in the week. And then when you look at the wheat complex, a lot of strength there. So we're up 7 cents today in Chicago. Wheat a penny in Minneapolis and KC up 0.75 cents, but it's the weeklies that have been big movers for wheat. Chicago up 31 and a half cents, Minneapolis up 16, and KC up 23 and a quarter. And like I said, it seems like corn is kind of stuck in between the two of them. So corn finding a little bit of pressure coming into the close. Majority of the day was spent about a penny higher, closing down 1 and 3 quarters on the day, but up 7 cents overall in the week. So you see that kind of tug in between soybeans and wheat overall, and trying just to decipher, what do we have for a problem out there? We've seen this spread really narrow up between December and July corn, with that demand being front loaded from China. We're not used to seeing that so much in corn. We are used to it in soybeans, but not so much in corn. And really, we haven't seen that selling pressure from the farmer yet, and that might be due to cash flow purposes of selling beans at profitable levels and not needing the storage for them, or just sitting here off another government payment, getting them by to waiting to sell some of their grain. So it'll be interesting to see how this spread plays itself out here over the next week or two, coming in closer to expiration. When you look at the cattle markets and hog markets, a little bit lower here today and overall in the week for cattle. Live cattle down 62 and a half, feeders over just $2 lower here on the week. Feeders anywhere from 87 and a half to $2 lower on the day, down 15 cents overall in the week. And then hog market down anywhere from 7.5 cents today to 87 and a half in deferred contracts. Weekly chart showing just over $8 gap here lower on the chart. But when you look at the December, that's a switch from contract to contract. December was actually positive here on the week, up just over $2.50. We do have the index continuing to rise for hogs, so that's been beneficial. Export sales were great in soybeans, not so well here into corn towards the bottom of the range, and big misses here for beef and pork here on the week. So moving forward, we're going to see what kind of yield estimates we get out there. A couple private estimates here today, 52 on the bean and 181 on corn. That is above what USDA has printed right now. So it'll be interesting to hear some more harvest and see if we see any selling pressure now that we're well above $4 on corn. I do have to close with a disclaimer. Trading futures and option involves risk loss. It's not suitable for all producers. This is a solicitation. Have a great day.